Heading this bulletin, a major shift in asylum seeker policy, with the federal government announcing that it will build two new detention centres to cope with overcrowding. Hundreds of children and families will also be moved out from behind the razor wire.
It's an issue that the Prime Minister acknowledges inflames community passions, but she says 700 children in immigration detention is unjustifiable, so they'll now be released on a case-by-case basis by June next year.
I don't think it's the Australian way to have kids behind razor wire in the hope that that may be a deterrent.
Australia's detention centres are under enormous strain, not helped by 106 boats arriving this year. So two new centres will be built, Northam near Perth for 1,500 single men and Inverbracky near Adelaide for vulnerable families. If needed, there'll be a new centre in Darwin and another expansion in Melbourne.
This is a government whose border protection policies have failed, their detention network has been swamped, and their only answer is to spend more taxpayers' money on more beds that will stop no boats.
Offshore processing and the deportation of non-genuine refugees will remain.
That is, at the end of the day, the biggest disincentive we can apply.
The government denies it's acting under pressure from the Greens. They're happy nonetheless.
Finally, we're seeing the government acknowledge that the current practice of detaining children and families in immigration detention is not right and it needs to change.
But the government has bowed to the Greens on one issue. For the first time in our decade-long military role in Afghanistan, the Parliament will debate our involvement beginning here tomorrow, with any MP who wants to contribute able to. And it's likely to be lively.
The sooner we can get out, the better, Paul. That'd be my philosophy.
It's very hard, and we should be openly debating and discussing the issues, warts and all.
Eddie Meyer, 10 News.